Hello, this is Rosanna Kelton. How are you doing? This is my studio talk. This is, as you can see, this is my studio. I work in a very small room. These are some of the Transchromi. These are fluorescent plexiglass that I worked with, and I created an installation with different colors. See, I have like different colors of plexiglass, and then I also use different lighting for the installation to show chromatic induction, you know, the transchromi plexiglass, fluorescent plexiglass, transchromi study of saturation. And then also I have here some of the silk screen, which I have been working with, and I'm getting a bigger silk screen so that I can do more silk screen work. And some of these, which you have not seen, these are some of my silk screen paintings, which they're not paintings, they're prints, but I'm working on that. Again, I'm preparing for the 45-hour review, so I have everything separate for that. And this is my studio. See, this is an example of the acrylic, large acrylic plexiglass. And it's a very large piece. See, it is 24 by 48. And I'm using these to do the study of saturation in the form of the transchromi. So you can see when you put this yellow and this pink together, you get like a reddish color here. And also, this is another painting that I worked on. And in this painting, I have over here, I worked on this. And this is also the vinyl and also acrylic paint. And I was trying to create more of the geometric shape, but in a larger scale. So this is really a 36 by 48 painting, and I want to do some of the prints, silk screens, with this size, with a larger size.
I deliver dynamic movement of hues by using repeated forms and geometric shapes with bright colors and robust textures in my work. I aim to communicate the properties of color according to saturation in my work by showing geometric structures that demonstrate reflection in terms of additive color, subtractive color, and chromatic induction and transchromi transparencies. I aim to communicate the property of hue in my work by painting artwork that shows simultaneous contrast. I looked for inspiration in my work at the optical artists of the 1950s and 1960s, such as Victor Vasarely, Joseph Albers, and Carlos Cruz Diaz. Some of my work is in fluorescent plexiglass, which studies color saturation and the fragmentation from the plane, and the liberation of color from a form, and transchromi fluorescent plexiglass transparencies. Other works have complex subsurface interactions that create light sensations. Since I am blind in my right eye, I process information differently from most everyone else, and I have less depth perception and field of vision. My eyes try to compensate, and I have learned to work with my disability. I do not look at my lack of vision as an obstacle, but rather as an experience. I have learned to grow from this experience. What I want to do with my paintings is I want to demonstrate that the language of color can be communicated to visually impaired people. I am researching ways to create this communication with other individuals that are visually impaired. I am going to demonstrate that the language of color can be communicated to visually impaired people in terms of saturation and hue. I am currently working with silk screens, printing and creating kinetic art installations that interact with visually impaired viewers.
This is Fractal Curves and Lines. It is an oil painting on linen. It has dimensions of 16 inches by 20 inches, and it has the illusion of a subsurface interaction with complexity and also the sensation of light. This is a line in motion, which is an oil painting that is 16 by 20, and it's an oil painting on linen. And what I'm trying to create in this work is the use of colors to create motion. As you can see, it's a motion in a static form.